The rulers of ancient Troy, King Priam and Queen Akuma, bore an exceptional daughter named Cassandra, who beginning in childhood had a penchant for asking questions too large for the mystics, or the philosophers, or even the mystic philosophers to answer. As she and her questions grew, so did her beauty, a quality that captured the gaze of Apollo. Driven by his enchantment, Apollo called upon Cassandra to join him at his temple upon Mount Olympus. Her mind still set on unanswered questions, she overestimated the god's powers and ceded to his request, on the condition that he would provide answers to her unending queries. Apollo agreed to answer one question each evening of her tenure, filled with anticipation of the knowledge that had haunted her since her youth. Cassandra rushed to the temple of Apollo, reaching its gates before his return. Waiting in the halls of the temple, she was greeted by two serpents, whose forked tongues licked clean her eyes and ears, allowing her to see and hear the future of all things but herself. Knowing now that Apollo would soon return, and that the god was destined to spend his days in loneliness, which meant her stay would not last long, Cassandra chose her first question. It was one of her grandest, near the base of all the others. The choice was an attempt to draw out a complex explanation, which would bear enough knowledge to resolve many other questions on her own. Upon Apollo's return, she greeted him gracefully and awaited the opportunity to put forth her question. A distracted gaze met all the festivities that were arranged for her arrival, and Apollo acknowledged it was time to lend his ear to her question. "How am I able to ask why?" she asked the god. Apollo hesitated and responded, "It is the nature of consciousness to be curious." Cassandra recognized the rhetoric she had become accustomed to hearing from the philosophers and mystics, and she persisted, demanding exactness in his answer. They quarreled, and becoming aware of the Olympian's ineptitude, she asked to be returned to her native soil. Enraged, but unable to undo the gift of prophecy given to her by the snakes, Apollo attempted to render the power useless by turning it backwards, filling her mind with images of the past, and cast her off Mount Olympus. Returned to Troy, Cassandra began to grow mad as her thoughts could not be turned away from events, places, and times that had preceded her, and the once beloved child was cast into a forgotten room in her parental palace. Given only a mirror as company, the Raven Woman began the arduous process of giving order to the visions of the past that clouded her mind. It is in this room that we begin our story, with Cassandra's eyes set on her reflection and her mind set on the beginning.
Thank you. Simplify.
as it fit better. But there must be a more elegant prediction in there someplace. Try again, Cassandra.
Disc of spinning. Disc so runs the Oh, Nothing explosion, singular haze, attraction, star, explosion, diverse haze, attraction, planet. My mind is growing weary. I think I must lie.